I think I'm just gonna cover the whole thing in deciduous and then... Yeah, you guys, I'm sorry. I know, you're not giving me smiley faces anymore. You're not happy. They've hatched in this strange place with no trees. Elephants are having babies. I know. You're not happy. You're just sad little babies. Hmm. Grass. Sand. Dirt. Fresh water. How's that? Is that enough fresh water? No. Hello, Five. Welcome to the party of misery. No one likes it here. Okay. Let's see, I'm gonna... I doubt they're gonna want enough sand for me to be able to put it all the way around. So I'm just gonna have like a little... kind of sandbar. Is that enough sand? Yes, now you want dirt. I'm gonna, I don't know. Dirt patch. I know, I covered up grass. It was because it didn't belong there. Okay, now more grass. Not bad. Oops. Now, what tree do you want? Ginkgo. They have a horrible, like, they sound like they've got, like, really bad smoker's cough. Oh, goodbye, Hoofy. Okay. Ooh, that's a horrible noise you're making. You guys just sound terrible. I hope your happy noise sounds better. That might be the iguanodons, that noise. Do I care about... I don't think I can just stay within like Cretaceous or whatever because I don't think there's very many. Yeah, that's like the only deciduous one that says Cretaceous on it. Well, these are in the wrong area, but... Europe. You don't want this, do you? Oh, you do! But it's from the wrong... I guess as long as it's from the correct time period, they don't care that it's from the wrong continent? Do you want this? Yeah, sure. Why the fuck not? Do you want this? You guys are not picky at all, are you? These are trees from completely different time periods and continents. And they don't give a damn. You know, I admire that. I respect that. These Pacific dogwoods are an interesting color. Okay, this is from the wrong continent and the wrong time period. They don't care? They're not bothered, as long as it's deciduous. Little bush. Yeah. Ooh! Highest quality exhibits for providing exhibits of the highest quality for animals. Yay! Good. Japanese maple. Stick just two of those in there. Put some snowbells in there. Put a bonsai, because why the fuck not? Put a trembling aspen. Just put a couple of them in the back. White oak. Why not? Put them by water. Cherry tree. Why not? Birch. Absolutely. Weeping willow. Deciduous forests always look so pretty. Put in an elm tree, I guess. Stick in a maple. Stick in some thornless mesquite trees. No? Ginkgo? Okay, so out of all the deciduous plants, this is the one that you do not like. Okay, that's a lot of ginkgo. Let's put in, I don't know. Let's put in some Pacific dogwoods. No? Have you guys finally had enough? No. They've had enough of the Pacific dogwood, but they never get tired of the ginkgo. I don't know how anyone is supposed to see them in this. Like, I'm trying to leave this area open. Because once they wander back here, no guest is going to be able to freaking see them. There's a lot. There's a lot of trees in here. No. Okay. Look at rocks. You're a deciduous rock. Give you another deciduous rock. Give you another deciduous- no. Absolutely not. What about just a regular rock? Did I not delete this rock? Okay. What about now? Okay, 90. I don't think that's bad. 90 is respectable. This forest is so dense. It's pretty. Hopefully when they're adults it'll be easier to see them in it. Yeah, we're gonna have pretty much the whole front be a viewing station. I guess the side can be one too. I I'm kind of changing my mind a bit. My ideas are evolving about, like, only having, like, the small viewing stations and then making the rest of it just, like, completely, like, concrete wall so no one can see through. I mean, if the animals don't mind being more visible, like, if they're cool with it, or if some of them even like the attention, you know, then maybe it isn't so bad having more surface area be visible. And if I get, like, a complaint, like, oh, the dinosaurs don't like this, then I can always just change some of the fence to something that the guests can't see through. Okay. Yeah, I'm not gonna connect this yet. I'm worried about this. Where are my maintenance workers? Actually, let me move this gate over here. Okay, where are my maintenance workers? Are you people happy? No, that's the wrong. 79, oh! Would you look at that? All I had to do was feed them. And get rid of a bunch of them. I think my population's gone down a lot. Fix fence, trash can, trash can. Okay, I'm gonna go out on a limb here and get a fifth one. Your name? I think you're a woman, but honestly, I don't care enough to check. Could you be selectable, please? Could you? Yeah, I'm gonna name you Tiffany. Tiffany sounds like a name I've already done, but you know, there's more than one Tiffany in the world. Okay. They're so cute. If I recall, they're pretty cool looking when they grow up, too. Where are the benches? Oh, I see them. Okay. We all know the drill here, right? Boink. 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 What am I doing? Where am I? Oh, I see. There we go. I just thought maybe it'd be a cool idea to have, like, all white ones on that one and then all black ones over here, like, for contrast. No, get out of there. No, I'm sorry. Yeah, fuck it. Kinda like color-coded. Benches. Bam. Bam. You are not where you should be. Bam. Get out of there. Bam. I can't see. Bam. Bam. I think that's in the right spot. Okay. That's nice. I haven't named you guys yet. I'll wait until you grow up. Because I think these guys look really different when they grow up. So, when they achieve their final form, I might have, like, different name ideas in my head for them. I don't want to jinx it, but these guys have been living a long-ass time. I'm happy about that. Okay. 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 Vladimir died. Okay, well at least you've got your son to hang out with. And I don't mean hang out with him that way. Just... I don't know. Your husband passed away. Your mate passed away. That's very sad. But, you know, you've got your child to get you through this rough time or whatever, so... Who died? 14. No, I sold 14. 13 died. Or 12. Or... Why are none of you missing your mate? There's only one male in here, so one of the females should be all like, oh, I can't find my mate, I'm sad. I'm not gonna complain about it. Markor. Oh, geez. Both of the other ones passed away. Okay, let's put some more Markor in there. Plop. Plop. I just named two Markor. Thoughtfully and I don't know. Rebelliously. Oh, that's so cute. They were all bounding around at the same time, but kind of like in different directions. That's sweet. Chester. Oh. Okay, well, if the male lions are starting to pass away, then I'm gonna put a female in there. Because she'll hopefully have cubs and then keep, like, the Cecil line going or whatever. Let's name her Sandy. Lion 46. Jesus. Sandy. There you go. Where did you come from? You're a baby. I guess someone had a baby. My notifications don't last very long. I guess while I was building up my Styracosaurus thing, people were having babies. Okay. Oh, wow. Getting that one extra maintenance worker really spruced these up. I'm seeing a bunch of green. That's good. Styracosaurs, warthogs. You guys had another baby, good for you. I think I already knew about that, though. Okay, so it's two adult ones that are a couple and then a baby. Except she just grew up. Or no, you're the baby. Okay, so she's still a baby. You know what it might have been with the elephants? Maybe I sold a bunch or whatever, and maybe 14 was like a grown-up baby that didn't have a mate, and I was all like, oh yeah, you know, he doesn't have a mate, I should get rid of him. But then I saw that there was a baby female, and I was like, oh, okay, well as soon as she grows up, there'll be mates. So maybe that's what that was all about, but even if that was the case, she grew up and they just weren't into each other, so it still didn't work out. You're sick. You're sick. Where's what's-his-face? Jeremy. Jeremy. Take care of the critter. No. He doesn't sound happy. He's healthy, though. Guest happiness 80. Jeez. Animal happiness 98. I'm quite impressed with that. Who's hungry? You guys have food down over here, don't you? You have two zookeepers. There's no reason for you guys to be low on food. No? There's Ron. Where's Chuck? 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 Chuck, there is nowhere else for you to be. What? Where are you? What the hell are you doing just standing out there? Okay, that's it. I think Chuck is suffering from burnout. You know, it happens to the best of us. I hired Ron thinking that Ron would help Chuck, so Chuck's performance wouldn't be suffering so much. And instead, Chuck just steps out for like a fucking cigarette or something and is just letting Ron do all the work. That's not fair. That is not how this was supposed to be. Chuck, what are you doing? Okay, see, that's what you're supposed to be doing. You're not supposed to be out there just observing. You're supposed to spend your life in here. You don't eat, you don't sleep, you don't go home, you just spend your life in this cage. That's your job. You knew this when you signed up. Look at this itsy bitsy little styracosaurus with this great big old pile of leaves. That's so cute. Kentrosaurus? Stegosaurus? Velociraptor. There's lots of cool stuff I could do. But I've only got so much room in this zoo. Yeah, there's black bear deciduous, but I've already got two really big deciduous exhibits. So for my alpine exhibit, I could do an Asian black bear. So I can still have a cute bear. It's not very big, though, is it? I mean, that's not its fault. They're about the same size. This one doesn't seem quite as burly. It seems a bit strand the poor thing up here. This seems a bit, like, skinnier. Like, more lean. It seems about the same size. Get a panda. I'm not really interested in that, though. A snow leopard. Oh. Styracosaurus thingy. I'm just gonna skim, and if you guys want to read, you can pause and everything. That's perfectly cool. Elephant 15 has given birth. That's great. Okay. I think I read something online about plateosaurs. I'm trying to remember. It was like some new or like relatively recent discovery. It was thought before that plateosaurs were like primarily on all fours, but they could stand up on two legs. And I think it's been discovered since that like due to like the way their legs are set up or whatever, it's actually much more likely that they were primarily, how do you pronounce it? Bipedal? On two legs? So technically, this game isn't correct. But, I mean, when it comes to dinosaurs, we're always finding out new crap, so it doesn't really matter. Let's see. More babies. I'm gonna have to keep an eye on you guys. Okay, how are the elephants doing? Does somebody want a mate? Seventeen is female and 18 is male. So that could definitely work. Aw, she just flopped over. But I haven't been paying enough attention to the breeding lines. I don't know if they're siblings or not. I don't know. Yeah, I'm interested in the Asian black bear. The moon bear. Oh, that's cool. I'm gonna end this session in just like 3 minutes or so, so I'm not gonna be able to start building the Asian black bear exhibit. But I'm gonna read through this now anyway. Yeah, they are pretty small for bears. Ooh, unlike American black bears, Asian black bears are quite aggressive and have been known to attack and kill humans. But this is possibly due to the fact that they are more likely to come into contact with people. Oh, they're endangered. Ew, bear bile. Oh, don't tell me that. I don't want to know about that. I don't want to know about them suffering. That's really sad. There's been little effort to preserve them. They're being kept captive and they're being held captive for their bile. That's fucking horrible. People do horrible things. Again, it's been like, what, 12 years since this game came out, so maybe the news for them has improved, like with the Markhors. The lion gave birth. Where's your babies? There's... Okay, you're a boy, 47, and you're a girl, 48. Meow! Gonna have to keep an eye on you guys and the inbreeding and stuff. Although I guess it is kind of like... I mean, royal families have been known to have some inbreeding going on, right? So maybe this is just part of the package. Snort. No! I don't want to sell the baby, I want to... Is it just you in there? How sad is that? He lost his parents. He's a little orphan giraffe. I'm gonna put a female in there with you. And we're gonna see if once you grow up... I mean, we're gonna see if you guys get like a mother-son thing going on, or we're gonna see if you guys can be like mates. I'm not going to name anybody yet, just because I don't know. She's not asking for a mate. So maybe she's accepted him. Oh, he just grew up. Maybe that's why. There, okay. I'm going to name him... I don't know. Antonio. And I'll name her... Okay. Okay. We're gonna go, blah, 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 use words. We're gonna call that good for this session. This is gonna be about 3 episodes, and I've done some pretty substantial building. They all grew up. Yeah, they don't get very big. Yeah, I'm gonna have to name them when we get back. I'll do it right now. Spike. See, that's what comes to mind. Spike and... I'm gonna try to give them, like, real tough guy names, like Spike and Merle and please take care of Antonio. I don't know. I'm trying to think of, like, tough guy names. Tony. I've already gotten Antonio, but it's not quite the same thing. Benson? Is Benson, like, a tough, bad boy name? I'm completely blanking. Okay, Carl. I'm not naming him after Walking Dead Carl. I'm naming him after Carl from the video game Soma. And if I recall, I might not be spelling it right. Strohmeyer was a pretty tough dude from that game, too, so. That's for everybody. Strohmeyer, Carl, Spike, Tony. Okay. Now we're calling that good. Let me check on Antonio. Okay, he's good. Okay, I'll see you guys next time.